McPherson is back in the building. You know what? A lot of us are intimidated to make squash. Sometimes I'm guilty of buying it already cubed because it seems like a lot of work, Marlene. But you say it's easy.
It is easy.
Okay.
But
so you start with
this. Okay. Okay.
You rinse it.
Yeah. But we're going to take the peel off. So we don't.
Always rinse it, though.
Okay. So
people touch it.
Okay, so rinse it. Okay. So Dina rinses, Marlene not so much. And then we're going to peel. So a good peeler, something that holds in your hand well, right? You're going to peel. Look at how easy this is.
Like a potato.
Like an apple. Look.
This is where I mess up. I always cut it in half first and I take the seeds out.
Well, you could. I just find it easier to hold and peel this way, right? Now, the idea then is we're going to chop the bottom so we've got a nice edge to work with. We're going to chop the top and then you're going to chop it in smaller blocks. Now, some people microwave to make it soft, right?
What about the seeds?
See, this is not hard.
You know what, you have a good knife. It's all about the tools.
It is about the knife. But you can always go like that and just keep your hand away.
Okay.
Okay. And then you just, what I do is I just chunk it down into smaller chunks, right? So that my chunks are small and I just keep going, right?
Oh, this one's seedless.
No, hon. It's down in here.
Okay.
But that's okay. Okay. So we peel that in this squash. So this is all about squash and we're going to do two or three things with squash because that's what we do. Okay.
And it's so good for you.
That's what we do.
And it's so good for you.
It's in season. It's inexpensive right now. So what we're going to do is make a soup. If you have at home right now, an apple, preferably a Granny Smith, a red onion or an onion. Okay. And you have a squash, then what you're going to do is we're going to cube this up. Okay, see how easy this is?
You make it look easy.
Well, not really so much, but it's not that hard, right?
Or
I wouldn't be doing it. Okay, so we're gonna put some apple. Here's the key, squash and apple go lovely together. And guess what, when you roast apples, look at me whip this stuff around. Okay, it's absolutely beautiful. So what we're gonna do.
So instead of using cream, which people often pair with things like squash to give it the thickness, you're creating it with really healthy tart green apples and onions to make it caramelized. Sauce.
Do you know why I use a green apple?
Why?
Because green apples are thickeners. You can make strawberry jam, you can make a soup, you can make a stew with one green apple, and it thickens like a potato.
It makes sense, like applesauce.
You got it. Mm-hmm. So look at this. This is absolutely beautiful. We toss that around, we roast it, and over here I have the roasted Finnish fennelé.
How long did we roast and at what temperature?
Okay, 375 and for about 20 minutes. Watch your oven. What I don't want is really burnt apples, okay, because they're sweet, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to toss all of this in, but you know what I would do?
What?
I would reserve about a cup of this, because what I do is I mix it with my hummus. It's roasted apple and onion and squash, and you roast and you mix that up with your hummus. It's absolutely
That's
beautiful.
So smart of you.
Well, it happens sometimes, Dina.
Wait, you only put salt and pepper and olive oil on this?
That's it.
Okay.
And you know what? We're not going to add anything to the soup. So you know what? Look at how quick this was. This roasted.
That's
you could
nice
have come
gosh.
Home from work, had this all in. Bada boom, bada bing.
You wouldn't cover this either because you wanted to get the caramelized with aluminum foil. You wouldn't cover it.
No. I want to just keep that like that. We're not broiling or anything like that. We got it in a really good pan and we're just going to actually
bake it.
Yes. 375 is fine, but roast. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this vegetable broth, organic broth, whatever, you know, floats your boat. You're going to put that in. You're going to put all of that in.
Mm.
You know, if you buy a Tetra box, it's about one Tetra box, depending on size of family. And here's the kicker. What's so good for us is
cumin?
No.
Turmeric.
Guess.
Oh, what is that?
Oh.
Mm.
You know what? There's a prize. It's a leapfrog if you
want. Cardamom?
No.
What's it start with?
Cumin.
Curry.
Yeah. Ooh, that's so exciting.
It smells
okay,
so good.
So we're gonna put a bunch of that. It doesn't really matter. Tablespoon. It's so good for you. Dr. Oz says eat.
Mm.
We're gonna turn this on. We're gonna cook this, and then here's what we're gonna do. Because we want it nice and thick and rich, we're gonna back
that's
away.
That's the trick.
Hold on. This is actually what I do at home.
Splatterproof.
Yeah. Does that look okay?
Put on the bib.
Okay. So then I go. Oh no, that's really gonna splatter.
More. Look, now you're ruining your nice blue shirt. Let's
pretend. This is not good. Let's pretend we know what we're doing. Okay, there we go. Good.
You
good
know
demonstration.
What? I am shocked that there is no cream in there. If you look at this
there
color,
there is no cream.
You would think that there would be dollops and cups of it in there.
There's none. That
Healthy.
Is the dish. That is all there is to it. The Granny Smith is a thickener, okay? So then what I did was I took my basic hummus recipe, I took the roasted vegetables that we did from here, and I pulse them, if you will, and got it out. And I like to put the apples with the hummus because the apple flavor's coming through. I always put a little bit of apple decoration on just because I want people to know when they're digging in there's going to be some apple
Fancy
flavor.
Fancy, aware of it.
I can take this off now. This
Great
is embarrassing.
Way to sneak in veggies with the kids, by the way. A lot of kids love hummus.
Kids
they
love
don't, by the way, a lot of kids love hummus.
Kids
they
love
don't
this.
Love squash.
It's like tomato soup. right? Like it's like a lot of kids like tomato soup. It's really, really good. It's a nice flavor. They've got curry. Now, this is what I did. I made a basic risotto. I keep a cup of this in the fridge. This is like refrigerator real estate, right? Yeah. I mixed it in at the end. Look, you've got curry, you've got apple, you've got, it's so, so easy. So
fresh Parmesan.
Keep this. Yes, you have to keep a cup of this in the fridge so that you've
You're
got
awesome.
This.
You're awesome. Make sure you watch Marlene's Harvest. It's on Rogers Television, and you can catch that every Sunday at 6:30 right on Rogers York Region. Yay. As well, make sure you get it. It's cooked once, produced twice. It's with fresh farm ingredients. You're all about local eating. RogersTV.com/Marlene's Harvest and follow her as we all do on Twitter at Marlene's Mission. It's her mission to get you eating healthy and quickly. Thank you so much, sweetie.
Thank you, Dom.
Happy Halloween.
Yes.
Halloween orange.